The Condition of Education is an annual report to Congress. The report has 42 key indicators, some of which are highlighted here, plus spotlights on issues of current interest. The key indicators of the condition of education are divided into four chapters. The first is Population Characteristics, which focuses on the educational attainment and economic outcomes of the nation as a whole. In 2012, 90% of young adults had a high school diploma or its equivalent, one-third had a four-year degree, and 7% had a graduate degree. Those who had completed higher levels of education had higher median earnings. For example, those with a college degree earned more than twice as much as high school dropouts, and earnings were higher for men at each level. Next is participation in education, or school enrollment, across all ages and levels. Enrollment in full-day preschool has increased over the last 30 years for 3-, 4-, and 5-year-olds, with most of the increase happening before the year 2000. In fall 2010, there were 49.5 million students enrolled in public elementary and secondary schools, a number that is projected to grow to over 53 million by fall 2021. Within the public school system, enrollment in charter schools has increased over the last decade from 300,000 students to 1.8 million. Total enrollment in private schools was 5.5 million students in fall 2009, down from 6.3 million in 2005. Enrollment in Catholic schools has been decreasing since 2001. College enrollment has been increasing over the last several decades and is projected to continue to increase in the next 10 years. It's expected that female students will be nearly 60% of undergraduate enrollment by 2021. The third chapter of the Condition of Education focuses on K-12 education in the United States. One change in the climate of elementary and secondary schools over the last 50 years has been a decrease in the number of pupils per teacher. However, in the last 2 years, this average has increased slightly. Another change to the climate of schools comes in the form of increased safety. From 1992 to 2011, the rate of crime against students ages 12 to 17 declined from 181 victimizations per 1,000 students at school to 49, and from 173 per 1,000 students away from school to 38. Turning to student progress, over 78% of high school students graduated on time with a regular diploma in the 2009-10 school year, a number that has steadily improved in recent years. Status dropout rates have been improving also, from 12% in 1990 to 7% in 2011. In 2011, 14% of Hispanic 16 to 24-year-olds were not in school and did not have a high school diploma or its equivalent, compared to 7% of Black and 5% of white young adults. Finally, we turn to post-secondary education in the United States. There has not been much change in the number of public or private nonprofit four-year institutions in the last decade. However, in the last 10 years, the number of private for-profit four-year institutions has more than tripled. While most of the undergraduate enrollment at public and private nonprofit institutions were young adults under the age of 25, at private for-profit four-year schools, over one-third of the students were between the ages 25 and 34, and another third were 35 and older. The highest average cost of college attendance, including tuition and fees, room and board, and books and transportation, was at private nonprofit institutions in 2011, followed by private for-profit institutions, and then in-state students at public institutions. College graduation rates are often based on allowing 6 years for completion of a bachelor's degree. 56% of male students, and 61% of female students who began their bachelor's degree in the fall of 2005 and did not transfer had completed their degree by 2011. These six-year rates were highest at private nonprofit institutions and lowest at private for-profit institutions. Finally, in the last 10 years, the number of bachelor's degrees awarded in a given year increased from 1.2 million to 1.7 million, while the number of master's degrees increased from under 500,000 to over 700,000. For more information on the condition of education, visit nces.ed.gov.